السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
يا الله يا رحمن يا رحيم، يا ملك يا قدوس يا سلام.
So this is why a winner is the one who can make a dua, especially now in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Ya Allah, give my enemies also Jannah. From amongst the Muslimin who have made my life difficult, give my enemies Jannah. When you make that dua, the angels say, oh Allah, give that one even better than what he's asked for his enemies. The angels are making the same dua for you, but it needs a heart made of gold. And gold doesn't rust, inshallah. You see, gold is a metal that won't rust, inshallah. It needs a heart of gold to make that dua empty of rust, free of rust. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the deep understanding. What does it cost us to make dua for others? Do you know when you make a dua for someone else, the angels say Ameen to that dua? So if you say, Ya Allah, forgive them, the angels are saying, oh Allah, grant him same, grant him the same. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really grant us goodness. Sometimes we become so stingy when someone is getting something similar to us, we don't want. There is a joke on a lighter note, I think I should share it. People are looking very serious today. They say there was a man who had 3 wishes on condition that his worst enemy was to be given double that which he wished. So whatever he wanted, he would have got, but his worst enemy was to get double. I'm showing you stinginess of man, how stingy man is. Even though he is getting what he wants, he doesn't want his enemy to get more. Come on, you said you want 1 billion rands, you get 1 billion. If he gets 2 billion, so what? That's him. So the first thing he asked for, a beautiful house. So he got a beautiful house and his enemy got a double beautiful house. Even more beautiful. Subhanallah. He looked and he was gritting his teeth. Wow. It shouldn't have happened. That's how stingy man is. So the second wish, he wished for the most merchandise he could have ever had. A large amount. He got that huge amount, a mountain full. His enemy got 2 mountains full. He's looking and he says, hey, now I've got everything I want. I got a beautiful home. I got a mountain full of wealth. But my enemy is across the road there. I can't stand that. He says, okay, my third wish, just scare me half to death. So he was scared half to death and he wanted his enemy to be scared to death itself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
كل نفس ذائقة الموت.
Every soul shall taste death. I will taste it and you will taste it. Those before us have already tasted it. Those to come after us will also taste it. After they have become alive, the next step is death. You can't live and then you have another birth and then a third birth and a fourth birth. No, you are born, the next step is death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding. And Fir'aun says, I now accept the Rabb of Musa and Harun. Allah says,
Al-ana wa qad asayta qablu wa kunta minal mufsidin.
Is it now that you want to turn? When you were corrupt for so long, Allahu Akbar, and you were transgressing for so long, now when death is coming to you, now you want to turn. Allah says, no, sorry, there's no chance for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us death in a condition where He is pleased with us. Salah is one of the main pillars, or the main pillar that upholds and uplifts the deen. Whoever holds it up will hold their deen. Whoever has discarded it has destroyed their deen. Shaitan's plan is to turn us away from salah. From the very beginning, he'll tell you, no, you're late, now just don't go. Because now you're late, you're gonna arrive there and look like a fool getting into the masjid when everyone is getting out. And this is why sometimes you have people who are quite mischievous when they are coming out of the masjid for Salatul Isha and they notice latecomers. They tell them, brother, you are early for Fajr, brother. Wallahi, that is actually a comment that is very cutting. No, they came late, so what? At least they didn't fall prey to shaitan. Luqman alayhi salam called his son. Allah loved the way he did it so much that Allah mentions it in the whole surah known as Surah Luqman. He speaks so beautifully to his son. He says, Ya bunayya, oh my beautiful son, aqim as-salata, establish your prayer.
خير الخلق كلهم.